Okay. Now, meanwhile, I have to discuss this, these insane, ridiculous stories today, the couple of insane and ridiculous stories. So, number one, Keira Knightley says that she is not going to allow her daughter to watch The Little Mermaid or Cinderella, which makes perfect sense because she played in Pirates of the Caribbean, a woman who had to be saved by a man. But here she is in talking about she's not going to let her kids watch Disney movies. I love how Pop Sugar covers this. Keira Knightley has a strict parenting rule about Disney movies, and the reason is spot on. Okay, what is her reason? Let's hear it from Keira Knightley.
And she's banned from seeing certain children's movies, right?
Yeah.
What are they?
Cinderella, banned. Because, you know, she waits around for a rich guy to rescue her. Don't rescue yourself, obviously.
Right.
And this is the one that I'm quite annoyed about because I really like the film, but Little Mermaid. I mean, the songs are great, but do not give your voice up for a man. Hello. Wow.
Okay, so The Little Mermaid is immoral, but for other reasons. The Little Mermaid is about a girl who decides to disobey her father, leave her culture, and go gallivanting around, even though she knows that her father is going to be turned into like a nematode. So that Little Mermaid has some serious problems with it. But Cinderella? Really? The message of Cinderella is wait around to be saved by a man? First of all, has she seen the modern version? The modern version is great. Have you guys seen the modern version of Cinderella? Like Justin and Senya, the one directed by Kenneth Branagh. It's terrific. It's a terrific, terrific film. It's really good. And if you think that Cinderella is supposed to be some sort of shrinking violet, you haven't even watched the original Cinderella. The original Cinderella, she's kind of sassy. If you go back and you watch it, it's actually true. But this idea, women can't be saved by men. Women, save yourselves. Listen, women should be independent. Women should save themselves. Also, there are situations in which women need men. It's called all of human history. And there are situations in which men need women, also called all of human history, but need each other in different ways. One of the great annoyances that I have with some of the modern Disney films is that every single Disney film is now concerned with this idea that women are deeply independent and they do not need a man. It's one of the reasons why Frozen is much more popular with critics than Tangled was, even though Tangled is by far the superior movie, because Tangled is about, yes, an independent young girl, but also about the guy she falls in love with who has to actually perform heroic feats in order to help her. That's okay. That's good for boys. And guess what? That doesn't mean that girls can always count on guys to save them. But when evil is afoot in the world, it is typically men who are going out there to meet the evil with a sword or a gun. Let's not pretend that all gender roles are the same. Now, I'm going to say something deeply controversial. Men and women are different. I know. Very controversial. And fairy tales tend to embed these ideas that men and women are different. That women are largely composed by evolution to help build, and men are largely built by evolution to help protect and defend, right? That this is the difference between men and women. Men are built to destroy things. They can build things too, but only when they are doing so for the purpose of cultivating a family or cultivating a civilization, which is where women come in, right? Women help build civilization by helping to tame men. Men help build civilization by being tamed by women. And also, I mean, this is what The Taming of the Shrew is really about. And also, by basically changing their destructive tendencies toward growth. Reinforcing those things is not a terrible thing. How many women have watched, like really, how many women have watched Cinderella and really been damaged by it? How many women have watched it? Like, is there a woman who watched Cinderella and then she was like, you know what? I'm just gonna sit here. I'm just gonna wait for a dude. I don't know what these women are thinking. And then Kristen Bell came out and she said something very similar. Kristen Bell said that Snow White sends the wrong message. Right now, I hope that she was joking. But I have no clue whether she was joking. I kind of doubt it. She says that Snow White sends kids a bad life lesson. She says every time we close Snow White, I look at my girls and ask, don't you think it's weird that Snow White didn't ask the old witch why she needed to eat the apple or where she got the apple? I would say, I would never take food from a stranger, would you? My kids are like, no. And I'm like, okay, I'm doing something right. Well, you don't actually have to teach your kids that. That's sort of the theme of the story, is that Snow White's an idiot, right? The theme of the story is that Snow White shouldn't be taking apples from strangers. And then she also says, don't you think it's weird the prince kisses Snow White without her permission? Because you cannot kiss someone if they're sleeping. Again, I don't know how many people actually think it's okay to kiss someone while they're sleeping, because it's weird. The whole point of that fairy tale and Sleeping Beauty is that it only works because it's true love's kiss, right? She's met the prince before. Okay, and the idea is that love overcomes even death. That is the actual theme of the fairy tales. But I guess we're going to rip all this stuff away in favor of surface messages about Me Too and women's empowerment. Really, really dumb stuff. Thank you.